Greetings, traders, and welcome back. Thank you for joining me again. Chris here, bringing you another survival guide. Today's subject will be candlestick patterns. This is a fun one for me specifically because I am a big TA trader myself. I love technical analysis, and candlestick patterns are at the core of technical analysis. It's been around since the 1700s. It's something that has been around for a while and will be around for a while because as we look through the market landscape, what do we see when we're looking at the different path that price has taken? We start to see certain shapes. And then as we continue looking and continue logging, humans found that some of these shapes are repetitive in nature in the market. The market itself is cyclical at its core, and as such, the idea is that these candlestick patterns will repeat themselves at some point in the future. So we're going to cover some of the bullish ones as well as some of the bearish ones. So without further ado, let's get going. Candlestick patterns are also referred to as Japanese candlestick charts or Japanese candlesticks as well. So you're going to see people talk about this online as well, arguing over what the correct terminology is, but realistically, there's just not much of an argument. In the 1700s, an individual by the name of Munehisa Homma was credited with starting the first candlestick pattern analysis. And essentially what they are, these charts are like what we were already looking at if you are totally brand new. It's a way of visually representing the historical location that price has been. It tells us what the open is, what the close is of a particular period of time, as well as tells us how far on the extremes it went during that period of time. So candlesticks themselves are going to give us information for whatever specified period of time that we set our charts to. So if these candlesticks over here are daily candlesticks, meaning we have our chart set to a daily time frame, every single candlestick, this guy and this guy, will represent all of the price movements that occurred during a one-day period. And it gives us some valuable information that we can assess and interpret in a relatively short period of time. That's the beauty of candlesticks, and that's why they are so incredibly popular. On a quick glance, we could analyze this bar on the left, and the first thing off the bat that we know with this guy here is that the price went up. What do we mean? Well, the price went up between the open and the close. And how do we know that? Well, the fat portion of the candle, okay, the big blocky portion of the candle, this guy here, this is what is referred to as the body. And the body represents the difference, the space between the body represents the amount of price change between the open and the close. That's what we've got going on with the body. Then you'll notice that there's this skinny portion that sticks out the bottom. And this is where the term candlestick comes from. This is what makes it look like a candlestick. It looks like we have a big wax body with a wick sticking out the top and or the bottom. Now, I don't know what candles you're buying. Mine generally don't have a wick out of the bottom, but in the trading world here, they do. So we have the wick that comes out of the top and the bottom, and this represents the extremes. This tells us where price was, but not where it opened and not where it closed. So it reached a high point up here at the very extreme end of the top of the wick, and it reached a low point down here at the very extreme end at the bottom of the wick. So we know that during a one-day period, just by a quick glance, we can see where price opened from the close of the previous day. We can see where price closed off at the end of the trading day. And during the day, we can see that it had an absolute low point down here, and we had an absolute high point up here. So just on a quick glance, one candle can tell us all of that information. So with this information coupled together with a couple candles, it starts to tell a story, and that's what candlestick patterns are. On the right-hand side here, you see yourself a red candlestick. What does that mean universally? Usually a red candlestick is a bearish candlestick. So right off the bat, that means that we are expecting to see that price closed downward. So with a red candlestick, the open is always going to be the top of the body, okay? So the top of the body here is always going to be the open for a bearish or red candlestick. And the close will always be the bottom of the body. So it's just simply inverse version of the bullish. With the bullish, because we know that it's colored green, that it went up, we know that it opened at the bottom and closed at the top, because that is what has to happen for something to close up. It has to have gone up in price. So once again, bullish candlesticks start off at the bottom. They open at the bottom of the body and close at the top of the body. And then the wick just tells us what happened during that day, during that period, whatever we have it set to. And then the bearish is just the opposite. The bearish opens at the top of the body and then closes at the bottom of the body. And then once again, the wick tells us more or less how excited price got throughout the trading day. Now we're going to take a look at some of these candlestick patterns when they start forming specific shapes where they've been recognized to potentially provide an expected outcome thereafter. And the first ones that we're going to go through will be bullish, and then we'll work our way into some bearish candlestick patterns. That means when I say bullish, I'm expecting an upward outcome after the pattern. If I say bearish, that means I'm expecting a downward outcome after the pattern. So our first one's going to be the morning star. The morning star is going to be a pattern where we have price kind of doing its thing, coming downward, and then all of a sudden we have ourselves this drop in price. Remember, with the bearish candlesticks, the red ones, we have an open at the top of the body, a close at the bottom of the body, and something crazy happened all the way down here. Price actually gapped all the way down here and opened down here and then closed upward, which is something that can happen with price. So we had a small body here with a small wick on either side, and this is called a morning star formation because it's standing out away from the rest of the bunch. After the formation of this, if we are given another candle here where we've got a bullish confirmation, this process here where we're going from this bearish to this bullish is considered a bullish read, and we would be expecting price to rise thereafter. Next up, we have the bullish engulfing candle. This one's quite fun. It's something that looks something akin to a big candle gobbling up the candle next to it. That's where the name, the engulfing portion, comes from. So what we need here is a big bullish candle to be gobbling up a bearish candle before that. Now, there's a trick with this one. The entire candle must be contained within the body of the big engulfing candle. So what we have here is a situation where the body is starting down here because it's a bullish candle, it's white, it's opening at the bottom of the body and closing at the top of the body like we discussed. And then as we look to the left, the bottom and the top is completely encasing all price movements from the previous candle. So this is a bullish engulfing candle because it is engulfing the candle prior, and the expected outcome after we see this two candle setup is a bullish outcome thereafter as well. Next up, we have one called the hammer. Collaborate and listen. Don't take me down off YouTube because of my terrible singing. Anyway, so what we have here is the hammer. This is a fun one too because another strong reversal indicator. This is going to literally look something like a hammer. We need price to gap down. So another gap is required for this pattern. So we need price to gap downward, then open at the bottom. We need a bullish candle here because this is a bullish hammer that we're looking at. And then it is going to work its way upward with almost no wick at the top. This is a perfect example because we have no wick at the top. It's okay if it has a little bit of a wick, but we do not want a large wick. The idea here is no wick at the top of this candle, preferably speaking, and a long wick underneath. What the wick underneath tells us in this scenario with the hammer here is that we had a large battle here with the buyers and the sellers, and ultimately it was the buyers that won during this candle. Why? Because price was all the way down here, but did not stay down there. Buyers pushed it back up, and we stayed and closed at the highest point of the candle. This is a strong bullish read, and after we see the formation of this, we are expecting a bullish move thereafter. Next up on the chopping block is the bullish harami. This is one that you will see quite often as well, but it is sometimes tricky to find. It can blend in with regular price movements. What we're looking for here is a downward movement in price because this is an idea that we're going to expect a bullish reversal after the harami has formed, the bullish harami that is. And so what we need here is a regular standard sized bearish candle here, but then what we have is a small candle Think of the engulfing setup that we talked about, but the other way around. So now we have a small bullish candle where the body is completely contained inside the harami. Harami actually means baby in Japanese, if I do remember correctly. Don't quote me on that one. But the idea here is this large candle is pregnant with a smaller candle. Sounds ridiculous, but the end outcome after we see this setup is we are expecting a bullish ride upwards. And the idea here is the reason that we're expecting this is because the lows are actually higher consecutively between these two candles, and we actually had the bulls hold through without pushing lower whatsoever, gaining traction from the time that the candle opened to the time that the candle closed. So we have a bullish harami in this scenario, and once again, we would expect price to work its way upwards. A lot of times with this pattern, traders are not interested in jumping in until price passes the high of the pregnant candle. So that would be somewhere over here where we'd be finally interested in a long if we were to take that ideology. Next up, we have another bullish pattern. This is the abandoned baby. All these babies all over the place. And with the abandoned baby, the bullish abandoned baby, what we need obviously is price to be coming down, because once again, it's a bullish pattern, which means it is a reversal of, well, I guess technically it doesn't have to be that way, but this is a bullish reversal. Should have said that. So what we have here is a trajectory where price is pushing downwards. And then we have this large gap where we have this lonely baby down here, just hanging out by itself. You know, someone called a 25 cent a day channel. So what we've got here is this baby, it jumped its way down. We have a large gap, and it's essentially going to be a doji. We want a very small candle here, almost no wick on the top side, no wick on the bottom side, basically looking like a plus sign. We don't want much of a body at all, and then we need another gap upwards. So this is a three candle pattern. We need a bearish candle to get us kicked off with the bullish baby setup. Then we need to have a gap down for our alone little baby. And then we need to have another gap upward. So it requires two gaps. We have another gap upward, and then we've got ourselves the bullish baby setup. And this overall is going to be a bullish trigger, meaning we're looking to go long, especially at the point that the bullish candle finally gets higher than the high of the bearish candle at the beginning of the setup. Now we've got ourselves a bearish candlestick pattern to throw into the bunch to give you an idea what these look like as well. So with this evening star, this is much like our morning star, just the other way around. So we need price to be working its way upwards, like this candle was doing. And then all of a sudden we had ourselves a gap upwards. Why do we have a gap upwards? Because bullish candles close at the top, bearish candles open at the top. So we actually opened up here even though we previously closed down here. So we've got ourselves a gap upwards, and you have a small, almost doji-like candle here. We have little to no body and little to no wick on either side as well. And once again, we are kind of just up there in the air, closing right around the high point of the bullish candle. And naturally, we're going to open at the close in most cases, and that's what we had, and then price continued to push down. So this is going to be the evening star setup, and realistically, the evening star is visible with just two candles, but if you want to wait for this third one over here for your confirmation, there's nothing wrong with that either. But the idea here is because it's a bearish setup, this is basically going to be identified with a bearish reversal in the market, meaning the market was traveling upwards, and then now we are expecting it to begin traveling downwards after this setup on the period that we're analyzing. When we throw another bearish pattern into the mix, once again, this is another pattern we're going to find when the market's getting ready to dump downwards in a lot of situations. What we have here is a situation where we have the shooting star, which is something like the evening star, but a little bit different. It's like an inverted hammer of sorts, but different with this nature that we've got this small little body here, little to no wick on the other side, but it is okay if we have a short wick on the other side of the shooting star. But once again, what we need here is little to no wick on the bottom side, an upside down hammer formation here, and then we've got ourselves a bearish push there after. The idea is this candle is standing alone, and we're seeing the momentum wean off, just like throwing a ball in the air right before it begins falling back down. That's what this is showing us here with this shooting star setup. And next up for another bearish candlestick pattern, we have the bearish harami cross. The bearish harami cross, and you guessed it, it does look, in fact, like a cross, which means we have little to no body for this pattern as well, and we actually do require a bit of a gap situation for the truest sense of the harami cross, because why? What are we looking for with harami? Pregnant candlesticks. That's what we've got. So here's the pregnant candlestick. It has contained the candlestick thereafter. So here's our baby that's sitting inside, and it is looking like a little bit of a cross. It has closed ourselves technically down. down. It is orange on my screen, which we are using to represent bearish candlesticks. It has opened, closed, and been contained with inside the pregnant candlestick on the left. And once again, because it is bearish, we are actually expecting a downward turn after this. This is akin to the previous pattern, telling us that the market is kind of running out of steam and falling off, just like that analogy that we used before that kind of applies here as well. In conclusion, candlestick patterns have been around for centuries and are still in use today, even by a lot of our traders that are currently passing the gauntlet mini. Remember to check that out if you think you have what it takes to be a successful trader. If you pass the gauntlet mini, you have the opportunity to get a deal. But other than that, folks, there are candlestick patterns in front of our eyes all the time. We can look at a chart and see a story unfold as long as we understand how to speak the language. I could talk about candlestick patterns for hours and hours, and if you'd like to hear me talk more about them, definitely mention it in the comments below and we'll see what we can do for you. But until next time, folks, thank you for joining me yet again. It has been a pleasure as always. I will see you all very soon. Cheers, folks.